Hey guys, today is my birthday and this is my first YouTube video. Likes are appreciated. As a patent engineer, I've been getting questions about coronavirus patents, and that's what this video is about. Let's get started. In this video, I want to answer two questions. The first question is, could the current COVID-19 virus have already been patented? And the second question I want to answer is, what do coronavirus patents look like and what can we gather from them in view of COVID-19? Could someone already own rights to COVID-19? Well, the Supreme Court has ruled that naturally occurring products are not patentable because this would impede innovation. As you can see from this article here, the WHO stated that COVID-19 was not made in a lab. So in this case, no one could be holding rights to COVID-19. But in a hypothetical situation where COVID-19 is man-made, then yes, COVID-19 could be patented. Just like how someone could have a patent for a genetically modified seed. There is another requirement, and that's that an invention is novel and useful. And that's why you'll see a lot of virus patents relating to treatments of diseases, because you need the virus to create the vaccine. Just like how you need the measles virus to create the measles vaccine. So in summary, could a virus like COVID-19 be patented? Well, the answer is yes and no. Merely discovering a naturally occurring virus is not patentable, whereas a modified man-made virus is. So at this point, you may be wondering, a virus can be patented for vaccines, but can it be patented for something like biological warfare? In this scenario, the US government could issue a national secrecy order, which keeps patent applications from being published or granted. Therefore, if there is a patent application filed on such a weaponizable virus, we wouldn't even know about it. And that's an interesting topic that I'm not going to get into right now, but if you are interested, let me know in the comments section and I'll make a separate video about it. Also, if you have any other ideas that you want me to cover relating to patents, let me know in the comments section. So I want to just go through a couple of patents related to this coronavirus subject. The first one I want to go through is titled Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome Coronavirus, which is SARS coronavirus. And the original assignee is Kiron Corporation, which I looked up, and eventually it was the vaccine department was for sale to GlaxoSmithKline, and I will get to that in a second. So this application was filed and it was not issued. Initially, the claim that they filed was ridiculously broad, and the examiner had to, you know, ask the applicant to narrow the claim so that it was allowed. Now, look how ridiculously broad this claim is, if I can get to it. This is a 893-page document here. One second. Right here. So, an isolated polypeptide of the SARS virus. So broad. There's no way in hell these attorneys thought they would actually get that claim, but hey, they tried it. Now, what the result was, and I went into the USPTO files to find this, is the examiner eventually did allow a quite detailed and narrow claim, and they forced the applicant to add all these elements for the claim to be allowable. To me, this seems like it is forcing the claim to be more so man-made, which makes the subject matter eligible for patentability. However, after this this is the funny part, after the examiner allowed this stuff, GlaxoSmithKline, as you can see here, let it go abandoned. So they got a notice of abandonment and there was nothing done after that. So perhaps the claim was too narrow and they thought it wasn't worth it. So now let me go to the next one. This one is applied by the Perbright Institute, which if you search the keywords Perbright Institute and Bill Gates and coronavirus patent into Google, you will find some conspiracy theories about Bill Gates owning a patent on coronavirus, which is falsified by a few sources. I'm going to let you guys make your own conclusions on that. So this one is actually called coronavirus, and which is very fitting given the current situation. And this application was actually allowed and issued. As you can see, it actually has a patent number. So the assignee actually owns the rights to the claims of this patent. Now let me look at the notice of allowability to see what the examiner said that made this allowed. It says the claimed live attenuated coronavirus is not naturally occurring. And that ties into what I was explaining earlier about how naturally occurring substances cannot be patented. It says it is made by a reverse genetic approach, which contains some identified mutations cited in the independent claim one. And independent claim one, well, let's look at the issued patent and see what was actually claimed. So we have a live attenuated coronavirus, all this stuff, exactly like the examiner asked the applicant to do. So here are two patents, application and an issued patent related to the coronavirus. I explained why they were allowed. And the interesting thing here is, I guess the question remains, are these patent claims broad enough to cover the current coronavirus? And the answer to that question, I can't give you. Only a bioengineer who's familiar with these this terminology will be able to tell you that. But my guess is these claims are too narrow to cover the current coronavirus, because the first one is an attenuated version of the SARS virus. And if you're curious about how to read patents and how I found all this information, such as these notice of abandonments and allowabilities and reasons for the examiner's acceptance, this is all publicly available information, and I can show you how to get to that information and how to digest it. It's actually quite interesting to me. But if you need me to look at some patent applications to determine the status and explain what's going on, and if it's interesting enough, I could do a video on that as well. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I plan on posting videos on finance, investing, technology, as well as patents. So why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button and like this video and hit that bell as well, so that you're in the loop with all my content. See you later.